We have a number of prestigious universities, but President Trump says conservative voices are being unfairly silenced at schools like ours and others all across the country. So today, he put forward his solution, threatening to pull billions of dollars in federal funding.
Under the guise of speech codes and safe spaces and trigger warnings, these universities have tried to restrict free thought, impose total conformity.
Joined on stage by college students, President Donald Trump signed his executive order aiming to guarantee all free speech on college campuses by pulling federal grant money from schools that don't comply.
We're living in a hyperpolarized time. There are many people who feel that if they don't agree with what somebody is saying, what they should do is try to shut that person down.
A distinguished lecturer at Georgetown Law and CEO of the Phi Beta Kappa Society, Frederick M. Lawrence, says the president should use his position to encourage all voices to be heard. However, Lawrence says the president's executive order is unnecessary because First Amendment rights are already protected and vague, not clearly stating how the program would work.
What this really does is that it involves, in a very blunt way, the administration in issues that are context-specific, campus-specific, and have to be treated in a much more nuanced way.
The issue grabbing recent headlines after this alleged attack on a conservative activist at UC Berkeley in February and violent protests in 2017 after Berkeley canceled a speech by controversial activist Milo Yiannopoulos. But Lawrence says universities do a better job promoting free speech than the headlines may indicate.
The University of California at Berkeley has spent close to $1 million protecting unpopular speakers and their right to come to campus. You know, the recent event that happened at Berkeley, that was an off-campus speaker and an off-campus person who assaulted him.
If a university does have its funding pulled, Lawrence says a legal challenge would likely be upheld based on grounds the order is too vague about how to comply. Now, today's executive order also addresses student loans, requiring better data for students about potential future earnings as well as financial risks. It also proposes institutions share some of those financial risks.